Thank you. On trombone. Jimmy Jefford on the bass clarinet. And on the first piece we play Dan McConkey on the alto saxophone. And Max Ellenberger on the tenor saxophone. And they're all going to disappear now. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you so much for coming in this evening. We opened our concert with a piece by our guest soloist, which is a piece called Elegy, written by Rufus Reid, who's going to be coming on in a moment here. And that's a homage to another very great bass player and very big inspiration to lots of jazz musicians, not only bass players, to the great Sam Jones. And the second piece was one written by me called Mary's Song. And now it's a real pleasure for me to introduce someone who has been a great inspiration to me and to our musicians here at this school. He's been here a few times, but not for many, many years. And so we're delighted to have an opportunity to welcome him back for this very specific thing we're doing in the second half, a wonderful suite of music inspired by the sculptures of Elizabeth Catlett. But for me, he's been a great inspiration, and for our students, he's been a wonderful teacher. And I'd like you to welcome to the stage Mr. Rufus Reid. going to take a minute for him to set up. I thought I'd stay on stage just in case. That is the case. He's got this very special instrument. Go ahead, Rufus. You can. You see this? He's got this instrument that actually folds down to go onto a plane, so that the top part comes off. And then he has also this incredible ability to adjust his bass that almost nobody else has. It's a very special engineered bass, and also a little bit of electronics there. You see, he's got his assistant there to help him plug in. I'll tell you what. While we're there, why don't I introduce the rest of the band who's over there? Michael Horner on the piano. And Dan Hester on the drums. And I can tell you that they're going to play a piece, wonderful piece, that lots of jazz musicians like to play, a great standard by Dave Brubeck, called In Your Own Sweet Way. Thank you.
Give him another hand. It's really beautiful. We're going to join forces here and play a relatively new composition of mine. It just got recorded last year. I have a trio, and I had an opportunity to record with the string quartet as well. And it's coming out on, you know, these black things, you know, these, you know, that we used to call records, you know. It's on vinyl today, and it's a label called Nouvelle Records. And I'm really happy about it. It came out about a year ago, and it was really a dream. So you can actually check Nouvelle Records and check out. They have a whole series of things that you might enjoy. And got a chance to play this composition. This one is a little different, and I'm not sure where the title came from, but it's called This I Ask of You.
Thank you. Thank you.
at the saxophone. Tim Bradley on the trumpet. Dom Stockbridge on guitar. Michael Horner on the piano. Sam Every on the drums. And Mr. Rufus Reid, the composer, on the bass.
Thank you very much. Boy, it's really, why is so quiet? Let's give this band a hand again. They're coming on the stage. This next piece, I was given the opportunity to, a gentleman gave me a commission. They gave a commission to three people to write something that was inspired by John Coltrane's A Love Supreme. And I was thankful that he didn't ask me to write an arrangement of that because I don't think I could have done that. It's an album that it's a pinnacle for me. And it's, as we say, it's a really a heavy piece of music. John Coltrane, even indirectly, has affected almost all of us because of what he has contributed to the world. And he came from walking on a piano playing rhythm and blues long a time ago. And I have an album that a couple ballad albums that I play. He did one with just ballads, and then one with a singer by the name of Johnny Hartman. And they're just beautiful recordings that you can sit by your fireplace and a little glass of cognac and really enjoy it. It puts a whole mood. And so this particular album, there's a lot of albums that I love of his, but when I started to put this piece of music together, I tried to cram in some things that affected me. The power of that quartet with Elvin Jones, Jimmy Garrison, and McCoy Tyner. Simply amazing. And then the ballads, it's beautiful. So I always think very much about how regal John Coltrane really is to me, and the patience that he had to have. He went to high school, he was from Philadelphia, and he went to high school with Jimmy Heath and Benny Golson. They were high school buddies, believe that or not. All three of them are pretty heavy saxophone players. And but Benny Golson told me one day they hadn't seen John in a couple weeks. Have you seen John? No. But the next time they saw him, he had something else to give them. It seems like when he went away, when he came back, he had he was amazing. So even those gentlemen who are pretty incredible players themselves were in awe of him even when he was in high school. So this is of regal patience. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We're going to take a brief pause, and don't leave. It's raining. You don't want to go outside. And we have a lot more music for you, the music from the, my Quiet Pride album that I was very fortunate to have two Grammy nominations in 2014 for. So we're going to play that suite for you tonight, and I actually do have some CDs, you know, those things that we don't have anymore. But we do have some CDs of Quiet Pride, should you like to take the music home after you hear it. But we're going to take a brief pause, and we'll be right back. Thank you so much.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I want to welcome all of you also watching us on Facebook. Thank you for joining us for this. And if you'd like to have a look at this after the evening's event, you can have a look on Facebook for a little period of time. Not sure quite how long, but a week or two, you'll be able to have a listen again to this concert. And, of course, afterward, you'll be able, to, if you like, to get a CD and have a CD signed by Rufus Reid. So it's now our pleasure to entertain you and enlighten you with this wonderful suite of music based on these sculptures by Elizabeth Catlett. This is Quiet Pride.
Thank you.
this next piece of music. My whole time getting a chance to write this music was pretty amazing. And I could tell you a whole lot about just the experience after I got a chance to actually meet and be in her home, and she in our home, Elizabeth Catlett. It has just enriched my whole life about everything. The mere fact that we're here performing this music is really quite special. She was a special woman and a special artist. As far as I'm concerned, she was a national treasure. So we're going to continue now with a piece that I really love. It's called Mother and Child.
Thank you.
This next piece is called Tapestry in the Sky, but the sculpture is it's called the Sky Stargazer. Duh. Stargazer. You know, when you're out in the middle of the woods, there's clear sky and you see nothing but stars, you can actually begin to daydream and get lost. Tapestry in the Sky. Thank you.
Thank you.
Keep your hands together for Grace Archer on the voice. Give her a hand. Yeah. Now you're going to actually hear some other things that she can do. This one is called Singing Head. We're come to the close of our program. I have one more piece for you. And before we play this last one, I have to give thanks to this gentleman who has made this possible for me to do whatever I do in London. Scott Stroman's responsible for it. So how about a hand for the maestro? Keep it up for this band. Keep it up for the band. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you. I want to thank all of you for being here. I know we have some friends and neighbors and families which are important to be in the audience, but you could have gone elsewhere, but you chose to come here. You're incredibly intelligent people. And I thank you so much for joining us and responding to these wonderful players. It's really a joy for me to play and see the next wave of players that are on the scene. And we're going to finish off with this piece that's called Glory. And I used to ask Elizabeth Catlett, I said, how do you come up with the titles of your sculptures? Because I know coming up with titles for our compositions sometimes can be a chore. And so she said, well, I was actually at a gathering in Los Angeles, and I saw this woman walking in the back of the room. I just liked the way her head looked. I said, what? And she says, yes, I met her, and I said, I would like to sculpt you. And she said, wow, what is your name? She says, my name is Glory. And I met Glory. I thought it was a profound title or something, but it was just happened to be this woman's name. But it was very special because Glory, Dr. Glory Van Scott, is still very much alive and a magnificent woman. And I got a chance to meet her, and she was really impressed because when I said, you wouldn't be by the chance the Glory that Elizabeth Catlett did a sculpture of, she said, what do you know about that? But indeed, it's been a pleasure to be here, and I look forward to coming back again, not in the too distant future. And thank you again for joining us. We're going to leave you with a piece called Glory. I'll be happy to be out and meet some of you out in the lobby afterwards. Thank you. Glory.
Orchestra. Rufus Reid. Go Rufus. Rufus Reid, everybody. Thank you very much. Thanks for coming. Have a very good evening.